Once you have decided to do IVF, there are several tests that you need to have to ensure optimal IVF success. Watch this video to learn about checking the function of the ovaries. Watch this episode to learn about pre-testing the sperm. In today's episode of Infertility TV, we will cover testing the uterus before IVF. When should testing of the uterus occur? IVF pre-testing of the uterus does not need to be performed before stimulation of the ovaries or egg retrieval. It must be performed before the embryo transfer. If your plan is to perform a fresh embryo transfer, so there is no gap between the retrieval and the transfer, then the IVF pre-testing for the uterus should be performed before starting the stimulation. If the plan is to have a frozen embryo transfer, which by the way, we strongly recommend, then evaluation of the uterine cavity can be performed either before or after the egg retrieval. There are two types of uterine cavity evaluation, direct and indirect. Direct evaluation involves looking inside the uterine cavity with a fiber optic scope known as a hysteroscope. Indirect evaluation involves using a method such as ultrasound or X-ray. Indirect evaluation is probably more common, but we believe that direct evaluation is better for IVF. In order to get an optimal evaluation of the uterine cavity, it should be opened up with fluid first. Remember, the uterine cavity isn't a big open space like a cave. The walls of the uterine cavity are pressed up against each other. Think of your tongue pressed up against the roof of your mouth. Separating the walls of the uterus will increase the ability to identify problems that could lower your IVF success rate. With an indirect evaluation, your doctor will place a catheter into the uterus and squirt some type of fluid inside. The fluid will cause the walls of the uterine cavity to separate. This opens up the cavity so that now it really is just like a cave. If your doctor is using ultrasound to view the uterus, the fluid used is simply salt water or saline. This type of indirect evaluation is known as a saline ultrasound or saline infusion sonogram or simply SIS. You might also hear it referred to as a hysterosonogram or HSN. This type of evaluation is good for determining whether the uterus has a normal shape and whether there are any structural abnormalities inside the uterine cavity, such as polyps, fibroids, or scar tissue. If your doctor is using X-rays to view the uterus, the fluid used is called contrast. The fluid contains iodine, which can be seen with X-ray imaging. This type of indirect evaluation is called a hysterosalpingogram, or HSG. An HSG is also good for detecting whether there are abnormalities in the shape of the uterus, but it is not as good for determining which type of uterine problem is causing the abnormalities in shape. Here's what I mean. Let's say your uterine cavity has an abnormal V shape instead of a normal triangular shape. Both the saline ultrasound and the HSG can tell you there is a split. The saline ultrasound can show the cavity and the muscle of the uterus, and therefore can distinguish between an abnormality called a uterine septum and another type called a bicornuate uterus. The HSG only shows the cavity of the uterus, not the muscle, so you wouldn't be able to tell the difference between those two types of uterine abnormalities. At IVF1, we prefer to use a direct evaluation of the uterine cavity. We feel there are a few advantages that hysteroscopy has over the other methods. First, hysteroscopy is the only method of evaluation in which you can actually see the uterine lining. This enables us to see problems that will be missed with either saline ultrasound or HSG. A second benefit of hysteroscopy is that it allows us to correct small abnormalities at the same time as we find them. That avoids having to bring the patient back a second time for correction. Whatever type of uterine pretesting your doctor performs, it is very important to correct those abnormalities before performing the embryo transfer. Polyps, fibroids, and scar tissue should be removed. Chronic inflammation should be treated. Uterine septums should be resected. Now, women who have a bicornuate uterus, however, may try an embryo transfer without surgery first. This is because this type of surgery is much more invasive. Hi, I'm Dr. Randy Morris. I give honest, science-based tips that have helped people all over the world have their rainbow baby. If you want to improve your odds for success, hit that subscribe button right now. It's like having a fertility specialist in your phone.